coming over there, the attenuation factor will be coming over there, all those things will be present over there. Now, it will be followed by one vision, and that after that in part 2, there will be interference effect. Interference, as I told before also, it may be constructive interference, it may be destructive interference, it may enlarge the effect of the signal or it may nullify the effect of the signal. But if the interference is in the form of noise, and in the most of the cases it will be in the form of noise, our main objective will be optimize that noise. Then there will be automatic meter reading and billing. That is a very important thing, because digital meter will be coming over there as well as smart meter will be coming over there. How the system can be made more automated one, so that it will be giving a proper HMI, that is human machine interference, all those things will be coming over there. Then simulators are there. There are lots of simulators used in power system we are doing. One is MATLAB, one is PSCAD. By the application of all those simulators, how we will achieve the result. We are aware of LabVIEW software. LabVIEW is the tool which is using for instrumentation, where we can use temperature control, pressure control, level control or flow control, or combination of all of them in a system, just to get a fruitful output. After that, for simulators there will be two classes. After that, SCADA and operating systems will be coming. For SCADA, one class will be spent, and for operating system another one class will be spent, and it will be followed by data logger and data display system. For data logger, half class is maximum. Data display system, of course, is a huge one. We will try to give you the essence of data display system in a very efficient and proficient way. 1.5 class will be spent for that. Then remote control instrumentation will be coming over there. Suppose some person is sitting in the console, that means in a confined room, and that person has to control all the functionalities within a plant, that means within a factory. How can that person will achieve that thing? So it is coming under that remote control instrumentation. Of course, it is a type of telemetry. It is under voltage telemetry as well as current, as well as power, as well as time telemetry. And then there will be quiz 2. After that, part 3 will be coming over there. Disturbance recorders are there, for which there will be two classes. That means two classes will be spent for disturbance recorders, followed by area and central control station instrumentation. For that, again two classes will be spent. For area control station instrumentation, for that there will be one class, and for central control station, which is the main console idea, for that there will be another one class. Frontiers of future power system instrumentation, including microprocessor based system. This is a very important topic, because all the things that will be guided previously by microprocessor, now it is guided by microcontrollers. As I told before also, it's a clock driven device, decision making device. Depending on instrumentation, there are languages like low level assembly or high level C languages by which we can guide microprocessor as well as microcontroller. They are the part of embedded systems. And after that, there will be the last portion, application of digital computers for data processing and online system control. For this application part, there will be two classes, and online system control, there will be another two classes. After that, quiz 3 and quiz 4 will be coming over there. Let me tell you that the books, the reference text as well as reference books that I will mention over here are the very good books for this thing. The first one is Cooper Elstree, Electrical Instrumentation and Measuring Technique under PHI, Pentecost, India. And the second one is of DC Nagra and KK Chaudhary, instrument measurement and analysis, that is of data microwave PMH. Now coming to this part. So, in a nutshell, I told you about the syllabus as well as the lesson plan, the number of lectures will be spent for that, what are the general topics that will be covered over here, and the text as well as reference books. So, if now I will come to this thing. Whenever we are talking about instrumentation, it is just like that, that there is a plant and along with there is a process. Now, how we can define plant and process, which is here I am just discussing about the general scope. Suppose this is a plant, this is a sama, this is an input, clear? After that, it can be given to a controller. Followed by an actuator, this is the place where you can introduce the noise. This is the feedback motion. This is going like this. So, actually up to this, this is the portion under plant. Process will be starting from here. Just see, whatever I have written, if this part is optional also, that means you can start directly from controller, then to actuator. Now, the thing is that controller and actuator, they are two types of, you can say, sensors as well as transducers. What is a transducer? It will convert one form of energy to another form. Say, mechanical to electrical. Say, optical to electrical. Say, optical to mechanical. Any one type of energy to another type. Actuator is actually depending on the nature of the controller. That means which actuator you will select, that will depend entirely on the controller. Now, how we can classify a controller? A controller may be a proportional, which is P10. Whatever input you will give over here, it will try to give the exact output as per the input. There will be integral controller. there will be derivative controller. Of course, derivative control is there. There will be proportional integral. There will be proportional derivative. There will be proportional integral derivative. This is the most important one where we are actually doing most of our work, PID. So, you can see also over there will be electronic controller, there will be other type of controllers also. If I will come to the portion of the actuator, it will be subdivided into hydraulic system, pneumatic system. Like in case of controller also we can say pneumatic controller, hydraulic controller, electrical controller, electronic controller, etc. Similarly, in case of actuator also, we can say that it will be consisting of, or it can be rather classified into pneumatic, hydraulic, electronic, electrical, different type of things. Because with the advent of technology, different type of actuators are coming. After that, the most important thing is there, which is known as control valve. The actuator is actually triggering the operation of the control valve. That means, suppose within a plant there will be some flow of fluid through pipes of certain dimensions. Now, or that fluid may be a liquid one, that fluid may be air of any gas, normal air, anything. Now, whether that fluid will go from one portion to another portion, one particular point to another particular point, that will be guided by all of them. First, the operation of controller is coming, which is followed by the operation of actuator, and at last, the operation of control valve will be coming over there. Whether the control valve will be open or whether the control valve will be closed, actuator is triggering that action. Whatever desired output you will get over here, we are telling that output as PV, process value. And whatever input we are talking over here, that is defined as SP, set point. Yes. So one is set point, another one is process value. You can see over here, I have put feedback over here also. Yes. So what is this feedback? What is this feedback actually? Feedback is actually a correction mechanism. That means every time it will just see the differences between the actual output with the, that means the experimental output with the theoretical output. That means whatever we want to observe as an output parameter, many times it is possible that we are not getting that exact value. So it will just compare those two values. According to that, feedback mechanism will be there. That feedback mechanism is nothing but the error correction mechanism, you can tell. It will again tweak the signal over here. This is nothing but a summer actually, which is actually seeing the differences between the output and input. That error will be fit to the controller directly. Actually from plant, the controller portion is starting, and then it will be given to the actuator in a different form of signal, and after that it will be given to control valve and noise will be introduced, and after that again feedback will be activated, and it will see again, it will again make the comparison whether the system is working properly or not. So, in short, this is actually the particular thing where we are getting that essence of power system instrumentation. Now, power system instrumentation is also aligned with telemetry. Where voltage telemetry is there, current telemetry is there, power telemetry is there, time telemetry is there. And in different telemetry, as per their characteristics, we will see different type of outputs. Okay? So, now if we will come to the question that what is the scope, what is the general scope of power system instrumentation? Power system, say for a factory, the power system is a very important thing. Why is it an important thing? Because the power system is the heartline. It will only guide the functional operation of that factory. The functionaries of the factory is guided by the power system. If it will hamper, or if the instrumentation of the power system will be hampered, then the factory will be malfunctioning. There will be heavy loss in terms of production. So, if we are not thorough in the theoretical part as well as the characteristics and application part of power system instrumentation, we cannot get the essence of the functioning operation inside a factory. As I told you, the process control is divided into several categories, like feed forward control, like feedback control I am showing you over here. There may be positive feedback, there may be negative feedback. Feed forward control is there also. With that there will be ratio control if multiple number of processes are introduced at the same time or at different time within a plant operation. Then how it will work, as well as there will be cascade operation. Of course, ratio control, that means in different time, in different ratio there will be introduced within a system. That means this particular portion will be functioning 40%, this will be functioning 30, this will be 20, this will be 10, like that. And in case of cascade control, how the cascade control will be there? If we will cascading or adding multiple number of process controls, then the cascade control operation will be there. Coming to this particular thing, if I will tell you that electrical instruments and meters, that means whatever we are using in power system instrumentation, it will primarily starting from digital voltmeter. Previously analog meters are there, where you are seeing pointers. Those pointers are controlled by either controlling torque or deflection torque or measuring torque, etc. So after analog meter, we introduced digital meter. Actually it was introduced in the 70s, this digital voltmeter introduced in the market, and nowadays everywhere we are using digital voltmeter because it is more accurate. The parallel error and every other torque error may not be present over there in digital voltmeter. Of course there will be some flickering because of transient output, and when we will get the steady state output value, the digital voltmeter is able to give you the exact reading. Of course, this digital voltmeter, in this we can see voltage in terms of volt or millivolt. There will be current that we will see in terms of milliampere or microampere, mainly milliampere. There will be power, voltage into current, that we can see over there. We can measure the resistance, we can measure the capacitance, we can measure the inductance. Even nowadays we can measure the frequency for operation. All those things we are using one particular term DPM, which is nothing but digital panel meter. There is one panel, that means there is one such display portion. On that, this output is displayed. 7 segment display will be there, like we are going A, B, C, D, E, F, G and dot. So that 7 segment display will be particularly present in digital panel meter. It may be common cathode type, it may be common anode type. After this digital panel meter, of course, there will be Q meter. There will be VCO, VCO and PLL, phase log loop and VCOs are there. Of course, there will be chart recorder, there will be data recorder, there will be disturbance recorder. All those things are the part of electrical meters. Of course, they are the part of power system instrumentation also. So, this is actually giving you the essence of power system instrumentation. That means how the power system instrumentation is working over there. Now suppose if I will tell you I have to control a very simple operation. Within a bucket there is water. I am applying some particular type of solution on that water in some particular ratio with respect to the volume of the water, and say within this second I want some operation, and for that I am using a stirrer. So how I can control that thing? There is a unique thing in instrumentation which is known as programmable logic control. It is known as PLC. PLC can be controlled by binary logic also. As we are knowing this thing very well, that any binary logic is guided by two binary numbers. That is why the name is binary. One is 0, another one is 1. So, there will be so much other notations, that is NO, NC, etc., by which the PLC will be operating. There will be several types of PLC makers in the market, like Mitsubishi, like Allen Bradley, like Siemens, like Philips, nowadays it is Infineon, etc. So, this programmable logic controller is doing that particular work. There will be some different type of program, some type of program in which you have to write. There will be branch operation. Every branch operation in PLC is known as RUG operation, R-U-G, through which we will see, we can analyze every single RUG output, and after that we will get the final value. One more classical example I can give you. Suppose there are two fluids, or say there is a conveyor belt. There is a conveyor belt on which there are several empty bottles. You have to fill up all those empty bottles by particular fluid, and that is also for some particular time period. That means one bottle is placed on the conveyor belt. It will just come under some filler. That filler will fill the particular bottle with some fluid. Within a second or within some particular time period, once when that fluid will be filled up, when that fluid will occupy the position within the bottle, when the bottle is filled up, that bottle just move from that position. That will be now the chance of next bottle to take its position under that filler. This classical operation is also done. Whatever we are seeing in TV or in view, this classical operation can also be done by PLC. Actually, PLC is a type of thing which is coming from direct digital control, DDC. Nowadays, we are very much aware of one particular thing which is known as DCS. DCS is nothing but distributed control system. What is distributed control system? Where we are using PLC, where we are using electrical meter, electrical instrument, data recorders, XY chart recorders, data loggers. Of course, process control will be introduced in the system. Maybe telemetry will be there also. Maybe there will be data channel transmission through any type of link, whether it is wired or wireless. All those things can come under distributed control system. The essence of distributed control system can be observable by the use of LabVIEW. This is an unique tool by which you can see simulation work you can do by MATLAB, you can do by PSCAD. Of course, Simulink is there also. Of course, with that, we are knowing that PSPICE is there also, or can PSPICE by me can also observe several types of operations. So, in short, I can tell you that in this particular subject, it is a combination of electrical, instrumentation, electronics, computer science. All these four things will be coming over there. Of course, as human-machine interference will be there, as well as mechatronics part will be there, as well as the construction part will be there of all those systems. Mechanical and civil is also aligned with, is also conjugated with power system instrumentation. So this particular subject is the combination of all these branches together in a conjugated form. That's why this subject is very important. So in the very first lecture, I want to tell you that any type of plant, any type of factory, whether it is a chemical factory, whether it is say business mall, whether it is an IT sector, whether it is some particular steel iron foundry or some particular other factories, everywhere we can see the power system instrumentation will be present, because everywhere without the presence of power system the thing cannot be. Even in this room also, if this there will be no power, then this camera will be off, then there will be no recording. It's another type of power system instrumentation. This camera is recording my movement, my lecture, whatever I am delivering. So it is another type of data logger or data recorder, you can say. So power system instrumentation is present everywhere within the society. Even in our room also, in our flat, in our residence also, fan, light, TV, flow of water, flow of tap water, inside your kitchen, inside your toilet, toiletry, or you can say air conditioning machine, microwave, washing machine, washing system, everywhere there will be certain type of control system. So control system which will be present over there, and wherever control system is present, power system instrumentation is present over there. Is it clear? Now the thing is very important that power system, whenever we are talking about power system instrumentation, we should go through all these particular things whenever whatever will come in this form. So we are also knowing that in power system instrumentation, there will be data transmission channel. How that data will be go from one place to another place? Of course, the data will be go in the form of binary from one place to another place. So all those things will be coming under this power system instrumentation. So, one more thing. It is a unique subject where we can do so many project works, so many live project works. Whenever we are talking about master degree programs, there are ample chance, there are ample scope that we have to expertise our knowledge, we have to venture our knowledge for a fruitful endeavor so that we can publish paper, we can publish conference paper, we can publish journal paper, even we can go beyond that, where we can go for some fruitful project work also. By those fruitful project work, what we can do? We can get some funding, and of course, it is a kind of joy whenever we are getting some very good results, because this is a field which can be aligned with artificial intelligence. This is the field which can be aligned with power system design. This is a field which can be aligned with power electronics. This is a field which can be aligned with utilization of electrical power. This is a field which can be aligned with ingredient. So all those things will be coming under this power system instrumentation. So from when we are just moving or marching from undergraduate to postgraduate, we can see over there there are ample scope, because all those collective ideas, all those knowledges will now be ventured in a fruitful way. So in the first lecture, I can say that not only the study is very much useful for power system instrumentation, but also you should do some research work, some good project work under the supervisor, under the expertise of supervisor, from any academia or from industry person. We are over here to share our knowledge, we are over here to give our best input for the fruitfulness of such a type of endeavor, where you can publish paper, where you can do research, where you can publish paper in referred conferences, as referred conference proceedings, as referred journals, where you can do projects, where you can do live projects, where you can publish your whatever your experience in electronic letters, etc. So, in the beginning class, that is the thing that I want to tell you, that power system instrumentation, it is a vast area which is involving so many things clubbed together. So now when we will just go for microwave link, as I told you, there will be T, there will be TM, there will be TEM, etc. All those things will be there. TE will be there, TM will be there, TEM will be there. All those things will be coming up over there. There will be waveguide also under microwave link. So the transmission channels, the transmission lines will be coming over there. There are four principal parameters: RSDC, resistance, capacitance, inductance and conductance. Two through, in that means two will be in series, two will be across, that means in parallel. All those things are very much important in transmission line as well as microwave radio. So whenever we will learn power system instrumentation, there is also a scope to study or to brush up your knowledge for electromagnetic field theory as well as microwave engineering. So that's all for my first lecture. Thank you very much. And of course, when I will deliver my next lecture, it will start with more profound things with electrical instruments and electrical meters.